Honorable Professor Wright, Dr. Peter Flugel, senior scholars like Dr. Hampa Nagarajaiya, so many faculty members of SOAS and research scholars and the professors came from India and friends. The topic of my today's lecture is newly discovered Jain mathematical manuscripts and their content. It is connected with three things: Jainism, mathematics, and manuscript. Jainism, there is no need to introduce Jainism because the conference organized by the Jain Center. Mathematics, I am a man of mathematics, and in ancient India, a branch of knowledge comes in the category of physical sciences. In ancient India, it was a part of astronomy, but nowadays it is very vast and varied, having several branches itself. And manuscript, a handwritten document, at least 75 years old, that has significant scientific, historical, or aesthetic values. It may be written on any material: stone, paper, cloth, wood, leather, brick bark, or palm leaf. So my topic is related with the three things. I will try to make the justice with all the three things, because it is related with the mathematics and Jainism both. So there is a class of the studies which is known as Jain School of Mathematics. So mathematics, question arises, what is Jain mathematics? Mathematics found in Jain canonical literature or in the literature written by Jain acharyas or Jain scholars is known as Jain School of Mathematics or simply Jain mathematics. It is a part of the Indian mathematics, hence we can call it Jaina School of Indian Mathematics. It is included in major class History of Mathematics. So some people ask me a question, what is Jain mathematics? It is arithmetic, algebra, geometry. We know the branch of the mathematics, analysis, pure mathematics, applied mathematics, which is Jain mathematics. So this is clarification that it is not a branch of the mathematics. Of course, according to American Mathematical Society classification, it comes under the major class History of Mathematics. When it came into picture, before 1929, no one knows the word Jain School of Mathematics. The first paper on Jain School of Mathematics was written by Professor B. Bidat in Calcutta, in Bulletin of Calcutta Mathematical Society. And first time he used the word Jain School of Mathematics. But Jain School of Mathematics came into picture without the name in 1908 when Professor David Eugen Smith, a well-known historian of mathematics, produced a paper, Ganitsar Sangraha of Mahavira Acharya, and a lecture was given in Rome, and it is published in Bibliotheca Mathematica. Ganitsar Sangraha, which is very popular and known text of Jain School of Mathematics, published by Madras government in 1912, with English translation of M. Rangacharya, and its Hindi translation by L.C. Jain appeared in 1963. Nowadays, the Kannada and Telugu translation are also available. So in this way, Jain school started to function in 1912, but the term coined in 1929. Now, why it should be studies? People say, why you are giving such emphasis on the studies of mathematics? Acharya Shri Mahapragya says that without the knowledge of the mathematics, no one can do justice with the Jain philosophical mathematics. And the reason is, according to Digambara classification, subject-wise classification, the entire Jain literature can be classified in four parts: Prathaman Yoga, Karnan Yoga, Charnan Yoga, and Dravyan Yoga. According to Shvetambara tradition, which is almost the same, the classification is Dharma Kathan Yoga, Charan Karnan Yoga, Ganitan Yoga, and Dravyan Yoga. So sections which are underlined means Karnan Yoga and Dravyan Yoga, and according to Shvetambara tradition, Karnan Yoga and the Gartan Yoga are full of mathematics. Regarding 72 arts, 72 arts, a reference of Ganit is found in Bhagavati Sutra, Lehiyao Ganiya Pahanao, means script, etc., but full of mathematics. That indicates the importance of mathematics in Jain canonical literature. Mahaviracharya's Ganit Sarasangra is a very popular text, and in that very text, in first chapter, he writes, Bahu bhirvi pralapaikim trailokke sacharachare yat kinchidastu tenatam ganitin nahi. Means, what is good of saying much in vain? Whatever there is in all the three worlds which are possessed of moving and non-moving things, all that in it cannot exist as apart from mathematics. Now, what is the purpose of developing mathematics in Jainism? Now, question arises, why the persons giving so much importance and the ancient Jain acharyas giving so much importance in importance to mathematics, and what is their purpose? The purpose is, broadly we can write some points, that is, to explain cosmological details and the description of the threefold universe. It is used in giving the length, area, and volume of the different section of this threefold universe. Because the cosmological studies cannot be made without the knowledge of the mathematics. So the for cosmology, cosmography, and the cosmogony, the knowledge of the mathematics is essential. The text like Suri Pragyapti, Chandra Pragyapti, Jambudi Pragyapti, Tiloy Parnati, Dhavala, Triloksar, Jambudi, Parnati, Sangho, etc. cannot be studied without the knowledge of the mathematics. Therefore, first purpose is to explain the cosmological details. The second is to explain different types and subtypes of the karmas, their operation of the uprising, binding, shedding of the karmas, and the net effect of their infinitude of combinations. Because there are two major fields, one the cosmological studies, another is the karmic studies. And regarding the karmic studies, the text Kasai Pahul, Churna Sutra, Gomatsar, Jeevakand, Karmakand, and the canonical text like Bhagavati Sutra, Sthanang Sutra are full of karmic theory. Dr. Shah is present here, who is introducing me. Is working on the Panch Sangraha and some other karmic text. So the studies of the karmic theory is another field in which mathematics used. Therefore, Jain Acharya giving much emphasis for the mathematics. And third one is to get the auspicious place and time for the religious ceremonies like Diksha and Pratistha. It is very much important. Without Muhurt, no Diksha performed in Jain tradition. So this is third reason. And the fourth is to train the people in basic mathematics, Laukik Ganit, required in daily life. Therefore, we find so many texts of Pati Ganit written by the Jain Acharyas just for the sake of the common person, because Jain Acharyas not only write the philosophical text, they write the text related with the mathematics, astronomy, grammar, and architect, etc. also, which are useful for the common man. And unfortunately, this part was ignored. If we put forward all these texts, then we find that Jain Acharyas are how much interested for the upliftment of the mankind and the society too. And to explain the Jain logic system, which is used for establishment of the logical facts and reconcilement of the others' views, modern mathematical logic is available in the text of the Jain Nyaya. As you know, Pramey Kamal Martand, Ashtasahasri, Nyayasar are the very famous texts of the Jain logic. And the Jain Nyaya text cannot be studied without the appropriate knowledge. In modern mathematics, we teach the students 4-5 operations in the Jain logic, and they are all similar to the operations which is used in the Jain logic too. Now, when these 5 are the purposes, then how many text was published so far? As I have mentioned earlier, that the canonical text, all the Angas, Upang, we are full of mathematics. Bhagavati Sutra, Sthanang Sutra, Aniyogdwar Sutra, Uttaradhyan Sutra, Jambudi Pragyapti, Suri Pragyapti, Chandra Pragyapti, and Shatkhandagam, Dhavala, Tilopanati, Tralokasar, Gomatsar, Jivkan, Karmkan are full of mathematics. But I am concentrating here non-canonical class. Non-canonical class, in this very class, which purely of mathematics, purely related with the mathematics, they have nothing to do with the philosophical details. And in this category, we find Trishatika of Sridharacharya. It is published in 1899 as a non-Jain text, and its new edition with the Sumedha translation appeared in 2004. The Ganesh Sar Sangraha of Mahaviracharya, first published, as I told you, in 1912. Hindi translation from Solapur, 1963, and Kannada translation from Homebush, 2000, and Telugu translation from Hyderabad in 2003. Ganit Tilak commentary on the Pati Ganita of Sripati, written by Sim Talapsuri, is published by Gaikwad Oriental Series in 1937. Behar Ganit, published by Madras government in 1955, and the new translation with Kannada translation and the English translation appeared in 2012, and this translation was made by Professor Padmavathamma, our senior colleague. A Ganesh Sarakomdi of Thakkar Feru, first published from Baroda in 1961, and recently Professor S.R. Sharma, he was initially in Aligarh Muslim University, and at present he is in Germany, with his team published a new edition of Ganesh Sarakomdi of Thakkar Feru, and that appeared from Manohar Books in 2009. And Ishtang Panchvinshatika of Tej Singh Suri appeared in 2006 with its English translation by Takao Hayashi, our friend. And of course, in mathematics, it is very difficult to translate the things, because for translating any Jain mathematical text, knowledge of the Jain philosophy, knowledge of the Prakrit or Sanskrit, or the language in which it is initially written, or the Kannada, which is a Kannadese, if it is in Kannadese script, then the knowledge of the Kannadese script is essential, and the knowledge of the mathematics too. So this is a very rare combination. Some people are expert in mathematics, they do not know the Kannada, they do not know the Prakrit, and if they do not, they know the Prakrit, then they are not well-versed with the Jain philosophical term, because so many philosophical terms come in the text that without knowledge of the subject matter, any mathematics, language, and the Jain philosophy, it is not possible to translate the thing. Therefore, in some cases, we get only original text. And Angul Saptati, Lilavati of Lal Chanda, Anka Prastar, and Jyotir Gyan Vidhi, these four texts, only original published so far, there is no translation is available. And as my topic is newly discovered Jain mathematical text, I am listing here 18 such mathematical texts which are unnoticed, unpublished, and I just want to introduce here first time this list here, so that the people who are capable to translate the Jain mathematical text come forward and re-earth all these things and translate it and prepare the critical edition, so that the humanity will benefit with the knowledge contained in this very. The Ganesh Satso Mahimodaya, written by Mahimodaya, and the manuscript is available in Abhay Granthagar of Bikaner. Ganesh Sar of Anand Kavi, this is also unpublished, unknown, in the History of Mathematics by David Eugenie Smith, in the History of Mathematics by History of Hindu Mathematics by B.B. Dutt, or any text of History of Mathematics, either published from Open University America or from any country, doesn't mention the name of these texts. Ganesh Sar of Anand Kavi, the manuscript is available in the Sethia Library, Bikaner. Ganividya Parnati, Oriental Manuscript Lab, Royal Asiatic Society of Bengal. And Ganesh Sar, Ganit Sangra by Yellacharya, it is available in Bhandarkal Oriental Research Institute of Pune. Kshetra Ganit of Nemi Chandra, it's only one copy available in Tholiya Upashray Grah of Ahmedabad. Kshetra Ganit of Som Tilak Suri, Its copy is available in Rajasthan Oriental Research Institute Library, Jodhpur, and Kshetra Samas Prakaran, Sri Chandrasuri. Its copy is mentioned in the Shantinath, in the catalogue of Shantinath Jain Bhandar, Kambe, 135 number, Vrat Kshetra Samas, Vratti Siddhasuri, and Lagu Kshetra Samas Vratti, Jaisalmer Bhandar, Kshetra Samas Ratnashekhar Suri, Rori 2536. Rori means Rajasthan Oriental Research Institute Library. And Kshetra Samas by Simitalak Suri, Uttar Chhattisitika by Sridhar in Karanja, Ganesh Shastra of Rajaditya, Madras, Ganesh Shastra Gunabhadra in Karanja, Ganita Vilas by Chandram in the Jain Math of Moodbadri. And it is Professor Hampana, I request to Professor Hampana, it is very difficult because they are in Kannada script. We are unable to even note the name of the manuscript because we do not know the Kannada script. So it is very much essential that a person who is well versed in the old Kannada script come forward, and there are so many manuscripts are available in the bhandars of Moodbadri. And especially in Moodbadri or in other bhandars of Karnataka, and the manuscript found in the bhandars of Karnataka are very reliable, very old, because they are all on palm leaf. And sometimes they are 800 or more than, the subscribing period is more than 800. So, but in North India, we find the manuscript 200, 300, 400 years old only, but in the South India, we find the more old copies. Ganesh Sangra Rajaditya, that is also available in Moodbadri. Ganit Vilas of Rajaditya, it is also available in Moodbadri. And Pudgal Bhangavritti by Nyay Vijay Ganiji, and this copy is available in Bhandarkar Oriental Research Institute, Pune. So these 18 manuscripts are available. Some of them I have seen personally, but I have not got the copy of these manuscripts. Now, I am giving you, as mentioned by Ratna Kumar Shah, that he collected 9 mathematical manuscripts. So, I have the copies of certain mathematical manuscripts which are not published. So, I am giving the details of one by one. This is Stang Panchavinshatika, the only one copy of Stang Panchvanshatika is available in the library of LD Institute, means Lal Bhai Dalpat Bhai Institute of Indology, Ahmedabad. And this is a manuscript of 3 folios only. Some details are given, and it is written by Lunka Gakshi Tej Singh Suriji, and he died in 1686, therefore it is sure that it is written before 1686, and subscribing period is 1813. The manuscript details are given here. Now, I have published his facsimiles in Aratvachan in 1988-89. Whenever I was doing PhD, I have got this copy of Stang Panchvanshatika. I am very much excited because nowhere the name is mentioned. Therefore, and it is not possible for me because it is very typical. So I have published facsimiles only with the introduction of Tej Singh Suri. So about the life, his case, the name of the guru, etc. It is a work of 25 verses on arbitrary disease. Each verse prescribes a series of calculation or an algorithm that returns any number, a positive integer with a certain constant number, say p, that is significant for Jainism. For example, in the first stanza, a constant is 72. And he narrated that 72 is the length of life of Bhagwan Mahavir. Length of life of Bhagwan Mahavir. Similarly, he given the some life span or the time spent for the establishment of the Lunka Gach. So many such type of things which are important from the history of Jainism are included, involved in 25 verses. Life span of the Bhagwan Parshnath. And a lot of controversy. Professor Sagar Malji is not here, but in spite of his absence, I'm mentioning that he raised so many questions about the period of the Lord Mahavir. But Almost all the people say that 527 BC is the Nirvana period of the Lord Mahavir. But in so many books published from Parshat Vidyashram Shodh Sansthan, he raised some question. Now, in this manuscript, the period of the Nirvana is mentioned 527 BC. So this small text is important in this way that he incorporated the mathematical skill to decipher or to give the different events of history of Jainism. And it is also important from this very point of view that with the help of this, we can resolve so many controversies too. It is composed in Sardul Vikridit and Vasant Tilaka meter. Last one is in Upjati. Many historical events are mentioned in this text, like Veer Nirvan. It is important to resolve the controversy regarding it. Now, the second is the Ganesar by Sridhara. And this is the first page of this very text. The name is Trishatika, which is popular, but the name which is mentioned in this very text is Ganesar. And the details of this very manuscript given here, the number of the manuscript, whenever I visited the Jain Math Moodbadri, I have found and I have taken the photo of certain pages, and Pooja Swamiji, Panditacharya Swamiji, previous one, now the Bhattarak Charukirtiji, not which is present, but previous Bhattarak Charukirtiji, who is named as the Panditacharya, kindly provided us the photo of all the palm leaf manuscript, all the palm leaves of this very manuscript. And so many copies of the Trishatika are available across the India, and not only India, in London too. Therefore, I am mentioning here in British Museum catalog number 5206, and under the name Patya Ganesar, India Office, London 6317, and Sindhya Oriental Research Institute, Ujjain, under the name Trishati, and in the Karanja Temple, under the name 2110. Several manuscripts of the Trishatika collected from various places laying in the Department of Mathematics, University of Lucknow. Professor A.N. Singh, previously the head of the department in the Lucknow University, and he is very much interested in Jain School of Mathematics. Professor Hiralal Jain inspired him to study Mathematics of Dhawla, and he write a very important paper, Mathematics of Dhawla, that is published with the Dhawla Book 4. And Jaina Sources for History of Mathematics is a very excellent paper, which is published in the Varni Commemorative Volume also. Therefore, he is very much interested, and he collected the several copies of the Trishatika, and they are all preserved. Not original copy, because no one will provide the original copy. So he take the photos. At that time, there was no so much facility of the photocopying. In 50s, I think photocopy method was not very popular. So he collected photo by camera, and sometimes he copied by hand, and they are preserved in the Department of Mathematics, University of Lucknow. But the published version of Trishatika, one published by published from Banaras in 1899, and it is edited by Sudhakar Dwivedi. And this will contain only 172 shlokas only. And the Trishatika, which is recently published in 2004, with the translation, Sumedha translation of Sudhyumna Acharya, and published by Rashtriya Sanskrit Sansthan, this contain only the same 172 shlokas. The published version contained 65 formulas and 107 examples. So 172. These figures doesn't match with the word Trishatika. As those person who know Sanskrit, Trishatika means 300. I have got a copy of the Ganesar from Moodbadri, and some copies are transcript of its Lucknow, from Lucknow University. On the basis of it, one enlarged edition has been prepared, which contained 305 plus 12. It is closer to word Trishatika. There, this is not exactly 300, but it is more closer to Trishatika. I think there will be some chepak which can be removed on the basis of the linguistic, and then a more, the enlarged edition have two important shlokas and they are missing here. So I am remembering, Natva janam savirchit patya ganatasya sar mudratya lok vyavaharaya pravakshatri Sri Dharacharya. So this is the shlok, this is the Mangalacharan, which is mentioned by Acharya Sridhara. And the second one is also the translation Sridharacharya bowing to Lord Jin tells the substance of mathematics as extracted from the party composed by himself for the use of the people. And the second sloka is Vrashave Sambhave Pancha Saptondurta Dishaye Vimale Ardham Chaturdwaram Kramanaikam Chadashate. So in this sloka, Vrishabha, Sambhava, we know that the name of the first Tirthankar is Vrishabhanath, third is the Sambhavanath, and the Vimalnath. These are the names of the Tirthankar, and the translation which is provided by the Suddhimna Achar, our other person is not, no. The translation which is made by Usha Asthana in the PhD thesis submitted in the Lucknow University is not proper. He translated Vimal as a cleaning. So this type of misinterpretation was made due to the fact the person is not aware with the Jain tradition or the Jain philosophy. That's why I have mentioned that the knowledge of the Jain philosophy is very much essential for the translation of the Jain mathematical text. The person who is not acquainted with the fact that the Vrishabh is the name of the first Tirthankara, Sambhavanath is the name of the third Tirthankara, how he will translate? And that's why he committed so many mistakes. And the another text of the same Sridhar, is I have got the three copies. One is available in Mudbadri, but I can't read it. Therefore, I am not given here. But the copy is available. I confirm with the Swami, Charukirtiji Swamiji, that the copy is available in the Mudbadri. And I have got the transcript of that very copy, which is available in the Ara. And that is the first copy, which is Jain Siddhanta Bhavan Ara. And the second is the copy which is found in the Elak Pannalal Saraswati Bhandar Ujjain. The three Bhandars, Elak Pannalal Saraswati Bhandar Mumbai, Elak Pannalal Saraswati Bhandar Ujjain, and Elak Pannalal Saraswati Bhandar Biyawar, Rajasthan. These three Bhandars are very rich. And those people who are interested in the Jain manuscript must visit these three Bhandars. Because I think that I have not seen, because he is very senior. Elak Pannalal ji collected several manuscripts, copied them, and put them in the Bhandars. Therefore, these Bhandars are very helpful for the study of the ancient text. Like Shravan Velugula, Mudbadri Bhandars. In Mudbadri Bhandar, we have got the Dhavla. In Mudbadri Bhandar, we have got the several copies of the text of the Acharya Kundukund. So, Jyotir Gyan Vidhi, and the details of the Jyotir Gyan Vidhi is given here. It is a text of astronomy. With the help, and important thing, Jyotir Gyan Vidhi is a very important text of the astronomy. The muhurt, the rules regarding finding the muhurt of Pratishtha is as it is quoted by Vasunandi Acharya in the Pratishtha part. But the original text, Jyotir Gyan Vidhi, is still unpublished. I have got the copy, two copies, and with the help we have prepared a list of the content. There are 10 chapters, Sangyadhikar, Dhruvadhikar, Tithyadhikar, Sankranti, Ratthohoratri, Pramanadhikar, Graha Nilayadhikar, Graha Yuddhadhikar, Grahanadhikar, Lagna Prakran, Ganitadhikar, and Muhurtadhikar. And this is very authentic. the people of the astronomy informed that the process of finding the muhurt and the lagna are still in use. And tithyadhikar, in that tithyadhikar, the rule of the Jain astronomy of Udayatithi are mentioned. There is a difference in the astronomical details of Jain and Hindu text. In Hindu text, the decision of the tithi is made on the basis of how long it is in that very day. But in Jain tradition, in the morning, if the two ghadi is that very tithi, then it is accepted. So this is the difference which is mentioned in the Bharati Jyotish by Dr. Naimi Chand Shastri Jyotishacharya. So the text is very important, and it should be published by any person who is well-versed in the Jain astronomy or Ganit Jyotish. Now, Shatrinshika. Shatrinshatika of Madhav Chandra Trivedi. As I have mentioned that Ganit Sar Sangraha is very important text and very popular too, because it is translation in Hindi, in English, in Kannada, in Telugu, and across the India, we find several copies of it. But a great mistake committed by the different persons who is engaged in this very work. The Shatrinshatika is a work of Madhav Chandra Trivedi, but everywhere it is mentioned as an incomplete copy of the Ganit Sar Sangraha. Here, on page number 35, which is shown here, it is mentioned, Shri Vitragaya Namah, 36 me sakal aat bhinna jati che, prakirnak das trairashik char, inta 36, Buddha Viracharya Ru, Pillaganatavanu, Madhav Chandra Trivedya. I have underlined this, Madhav Chandra Trivedya, Charya Ru, Sodh Siddharadis, Sodh Sangrahamenis Kum Buddhu. Buddhu Shriman, Pellaganit Pehle Kahege. These two words are from the Kannada background. Therefore, the northern Indian people cannot explain this very thing. When I visited Shravan Belgola, Pooj Bhattarak Swamiji, and Pandit Bahubali Upadhyay in 1981, assisted me, and he said that Pellaganit Mani Pehle Kahege, previously known, previously declared. And Buddhu means Shriman, Aap. It is a word of honor only. So whenever I have gone through the content of this very text, these are the details of manuscript and other manuscript. There are so many manuscripts I have found. And whenever I have examined that, if any manuscript by S.N. Sen mentioned as an incomplete manuscript by Professor L.C. Jain, Professor Hiralal Jain, Professor A.N. Upadhyay mentioned these are the incomplete manuscript of Ganit Sar Sangraha, I have found that, of course, they have the first four chapters, but these are the Ganit Sar Sangraha. First four chapters are same in Shatrinshatika. And he mentioned also that Sodh Siddharagi of Sar Sangraha. It means on the basis of the Ganit Sar Sangraha of Mahaviracharya, Madhav Chandra say that I have prepared this very short Shatrinshatika. So this is the verse portion, Shri Vitragaya Namah. This is the same thing. And the chapter of GSS, which is found in the Shatrinshatika, are following Sangyadhikar, Parikaram Vyavahar, Kala Savarna Vyavahar, Prakirnaka Vyavahar, and Trairashik Vyavahar. These four chapters are in the published version. Sangyadhikar and Parikaram Vyavahar are separated. So we find that these five chapters are the same. But in Shatrinshatika, we find these 13 additional formulae. Varga Sankalitanayana Sutram, Gana Sankalitanayana Sutram, Ek Dwaradi Sankalit Ghananayana Sutram, Sarva Ghananayana Sutra Dvayam, Uttarottarchay Bhava. So these 13 formulae, in the first four chapters, we find the operation of eight fundamental operations on fractions. Then Bhinna Jati means six type of fractions, and Prakirnak, operations and the applied questions related with the fractions and trirashik is well known to all of you, that regarding proportion, etc., ichhakar questions, they are trirashik. So the 36 type of things which is discussed in the first 5 chapter of the Ganeshasar Sangra are taken as it is. But there are certain things which is essential, and they are related with the series. They are related with the geometry, and they are related with the 2 typical problems which is discussed by the Acharya Sridhara. If 2 persons start from a same point with the 2 velocities, or after a period of half an hour, person start with the different velocity, when they will meet, this type of question is discussed in Pati Ganit by Sridharacharya. But in the first 4 or 5 chapters up to Trirashik, there is no details of such type of questions. So these type of question, how solve? So the formula for that very is given here. And Sanyoganayana Sutram, Sanyoganayana Sutram. Under this heading, the process of solving this type of situation is given. And a person borrows certain money from any vanik, any landlord, then what will be the interest, and in how many days? Even that EMI is a very popular word at present, word equally monthly installment. So what will be the equal monthly installment? This type of question is discussed here in Vanikkara Sthiti Gharanayana Sutram. So this type of with the problems, and typical problems, series and geometry are discussed, and under these 13 chapters are the formula with illustration, all the things discussed. Apart from it, Madhav Chandra Trivedi illustrated certain formulae which is given in the Ganeshasar Sangra with the help of certain examples added by him. And in the last, he has given the magic square of 34. In the Jain temples, we find the many yantras, they bear the different magic squares, 35, 25, 34, 25, 15, 64, etc. So what is the use and why they are given so much importance, I do not know, and I do not want to comment on it. But here it is important that they have mentioned the magic square of 34. Now, Lokan Yog, this is Jinsen, as I have told you, the Jains given much importance to cosmological studies, and entire Ganitan Yog is full of cosmological things. The details of this manuscript, and this manuscript is available in Kumbhoj Bahubali of Kolhapur, as well as in the Karanja Lad, and this written by the Acharya Jinsen. In Trailokya Deepaka Pandit Bamdev, we find a copy of it in Delhi, written in 1386. 1386. So this text is written before that. 1379. And so many copies are available in Khajuraho, in Chanderi, in Ujjain, and Trilok Darpan of Pandit Khadaksen. Khadaksen, nothing is new in this very script, but importance is this: it is first text of mathematics, cosmological mathematics, cosmological details, which is written in Devanagari script and in Hindi. In Hindi, as you know, Om Namah Siddhaya Shri Gurubhyo Namah Athi Trilok Darpan, Hindi Bhasha Likhyate. Om Namah Siddhan Munijan Rai. So this is in Hindi, this is its importance. So it is written in 1656. Several other manuscripts are available in Sonagir, Gwalior, Sivni Malwa, Indore, Sanawat, Bina, Sivni, Shivpuri, Khargapur, etc. And it is the oldest book on Jain cosmology written in Hindi. Of course, cosmological books are so many old, but in Hindi it is first book. And this is the Ganeshasar of Themraj of 17th century. This is the first text on number theory written in Hindi. And as Sri Yati Sundara, Sri Pati Sundara Sugata Vidhi Nirvikar Kartar Agam Sugam Anandamay Sur Narapati Suro Narapati Sartar. So in this way, it is the importance of this is it is written in Hindi, and we find in this that the type of number, countable, uncountable, and finite is mentioned in this very text, nothing else. In 89 shlokas, in 89 pad, it is mentioned, and Guru Prasad Avadhar Lokottara Giniti Karu, Trivid Tasu Parivar, Sankhya Sankhya Anantakari, Trivid Bhed Sankhyata Vichar, Asankhyat Nau Parakar, Nahi Vidijin Keho Anand, Avus Inko Sun Lo Virtant. This classification is available in Sthanang, in Bhagavati, in Anayogdwar, in Jammudi Pragyapti, in Tiloy Parnati, in Trilok Sar, in Jammudi Parnati Sango. Everywhere the same type of details is available. Somewhere we find minute details, difference in the Anantanant. In the Anantanant are the quantities which is added. We will find some difference. But in entire tradition, in Digambar and Shatambar both, this classification is almost 99% same. But the beauty of this is in Hindi. And he write, Sankhya Sankhya Anant ke ei bhed ikis, thul roop kinchit kahe, suksham jane is. So in this way, he has illustrated thing in very simple manner. Yes. And I have collected this very manuscript, which is shown here, from a small town, Ganj Basoda, Vidisha. And other known manuscripts are from Jaipur, Bundi, and a copy of the Bundi is available in Kundukund Gyanpit in the library. Ganesh Saraf Hemraj is probably first Indian completely mathematical text written in Hindi poetry. The text deals with the unique Jaina classification system of number. And there are some controversies about the Ganesh Sar Sangra. It is said that the mention that x upon 0 is equal to x is wrong. As a man of mathematics, I am also say that x upon 0 is not x. It should be infinity. Any number divided by 0 is infinity. But according to logical system, according to Nayayik point of view, if x thing is distributed among 0 person, what will be the change? If I have certain thing, these 100 books, and if we distribute in among the 0 person, means we not distribute, then the things will remain same. There will be no change. This is the idea. And this is ignored by M. Rangachari. And then they have copied only. The further translator copied or followed the view of the Rangachari. And this very Uttar Chhattisi Tika, which is recovered from the Byavar, the illustration is given that yx upon 0 is x mentioned by the Mahaviracharya. So certain charges, which is one more charge, the rule for finding the area of a quadrilateral, which is mentioned by the Ganesha Mahaviracharya, is not correct. But the things when we see that the rule, when illustrated with the example, that it is Chakriya Chaturbhuja. So this is a typical problem. And if it is used for that very case, then the rule is correct. And if we use it for general case, then it will be not proper. So whenever we find the certain commentaries, the formula and the validity of formula can be checked in more better way. And the limitation of the formula can be explained and analyzed with the help of certain such type of commentaries. The name is Uttar Chhattisi Tika, but really it is the commentary of the Ganesar Sangra made by Bhattarak Sumati Kirtiji, and so many copies of this is available, but this copy we have recovered from Biavar, another copy is available in Udaipur, etc. And recently, within 2-3 months, I have recovered Lagu Sangrahani Sutra from Hat Pipliya, a very small town of Devas district, and Sangrahani Sutra Balabodh by Ganesh Gyan Bhandar. It is from Gyan Gach of Sthanakvasi tradition, and this is a very old manuscript, about 600 years old, and it is recovered from Ratlam. Now, in this case, what is our responsibility? Our responsibility to get the copies of these manuscripts from the Bhandars and print the facsimiles or put them on the internet immediately so that the interested and the capable scholars may translate them and evaluate critically their content. Nowadays, people do not give easily the copy of the manuscript. And the Copyright Act creates so many problems. And National Mission for Manuscript, who collected the data of different Jain Bhandars, is bound not to put on the website because intellectual property right came in between. Therefore, I have contacted him. Alisandra is not here. She asked a question that is there is any commentary before Singh Tilak Suri is available in Jain tradition? I have analyzed 8,000 datas available with National Mission for Manuscript. Being a coordinator for Madhya Pradesh, I have a facility to enter in these datas. And I have found that no commentary before Singh Tilak Suri is written on any completely mathematical text. If she will come, she's doing work on Ganit Tilaka of Singh Tilak Suri. Tomorrow she may come. So then I will inform him. She mailed me and I have said that I will try to get the answer of your question. I have found that no commentary before Singh Tilak Suri is available according to my knowledge. There may be some. So if any commentary procured or found, then it will be an achievement. But this is the research. And if we find, then we change our idea. And naturally, this is my responsibility to acknowledge the assistance provided in collecting so many data, especially Jain Vishwabharati, Sansthan Ladnu, Gyan Sagar Science Foundation, National Mission for Manuscript, Government of India, and Kundukund Gyanpeet. All are very helpful, and with the help of these, we have collected these data, which will establish a foundation for the further studies in the field of Jain School of Mathematics. The text which is recovered so far are the canonical text. A lot of work has been done. Even then, so many texts of non-canonical castes are ignored, and they have a lot of information which is useful for us, and it is our responsibility to preserve them for the new generation, for further generation.